My book grew out of a series of revelations that led to some severe self-doubts. I heard a CBC radio interview with David Cesarani and with a Canadian professor who has been working on the Roy Farran case as well. And then I read the Cesarani book. This prompted me to the first stage of my reevaluation of Roy and me, which was an article in the Alberta Views. That article, once it appeared, led me to think further on the situation. I reviewed the Cesarani book for Alberta Views, and then I thought about writing a play in two voices, and that's the form that this book originally took. There was too much stuff to shove into a play, though, and so it took its present form, and it remains a memoir in voices. It's very much like a classic closet drama, where there are voices speaking and not much action going on. It's voices and minds clashing.